Hello everyone, this is Psychic704, and here's another pickups video. I don't do a lot of importing anymore, at least for older systems or buying older system games, because I don't have a lot that I want or care about getting anymore. I've done a pretty good job of getting what I've wanted to get, and not much really else outside of like something being too pricey and I don't really want it, or you know, those types of things. Or I just don't care, but yeah, I picked up a couple extra in the recent times. So, first one here is Rockman World 5. This Japanese version of Mega Man 5 for the Game Boy is much, much cheaper, so that's why I got that one, because you don't really need language to understand how to play Mega Man. And I've heard a lot of good things about this one. Actually, I've heard this is the best one on the Game Boy, so I assume it's probably pretty rare for the U.S. version, so I don't care. So, region free Game Boy, you know, works good that way. So I also got this along with it in the same order. I've been thinking about this one for a while, but it's a Double Dragon 3 for the NES. This one's subtitled the Rosetta Stone because it's the Japanese Famicom version. The U.S. version is subtitled the Sacred Stones, and it's the same game, so other than that. I did play through this recently. I remember playing it back in the day, like renting it and wanting to like it, and it's not very good. Well, I'm here to say, after once he's seeing this, it's not very good, actually. It's just kind of a bad game. Compared to other Double Dragon games, they're actually good, like the immediate predecessor to this one on the same system, and even the one previous to that, or the arcade version of 1 and 2, they're all better games. This one's alright, I guess, but it could be a lot worse. There are worse Double Dragon games, but I don't know, it just doesn't do much for me, and there's not much to the action or level design or anything like there is in other games in the series. So it kind of just blows, I guess. Kind of just blows. I also don't go out of town to go to shops all that often, like, you know, video game shops, obviously. And I found one in Mount Vernon, Ohio. It's not too far from where I am, so we've gone to Columbus, which is from many a shop, because it's just a lot bigger area that has a lot more, multiple times in the past, so decided why not. So we took time out, me and my brother went out to the one down called Gamescape in Mount Vernon. Pretty cool place. Bigger, pretty big. I saw pictures online ahead of time. It looks pretty nice and big, and it is. So I picked up a few things from there. Three things overall. Two games and a controller. First off was a copy of the Combat Tribes for the Super Nintendo. It's another Technos game like that Double Dragon 3. Also made basically the year after Double Dragon 3 on NES, I think. And not a great game either, but neither was the arcade version, which I also played back in the day. It's around here in Mladen's Castle, I remember. It's alright though, you know, whatever. It's got its little charms, but it's pretty easy. Oh, by the way, this was really shitty looking when I picked it up from that store. Had white marker numbers here and on the sides, both sides, and all across this back sticker and here. So you're probably thinking, man, you really cleaned that up. Well, kind of. There was also like remnants of those, you know, those silver rental like anti-theft stickers or whatever the fuck, like right around this area, and then some residue here, so that really cleaned up well. And I did get rid of this one on the front, though I had to do it in ways that, if you can maybe see there, you can definitely see that. I had to scrub away some of the texture to get it to actually get off there, because print marker on these textured plastics is just sucks to get off. You basically can't really do it without fucking it up a little bit. But it is a little bit, so it's not a huge big deal. So what I did to get rid of the rest of this, because I knew I couldn't get the marker off of this label on the back that was originally there, it just would have ruined the label, whatever I would have done. It just, no way. So I just went to a local store, bought a cheap title that no one cares about and no one wants. That's why it's cheap and no one cares and it's common. And I found one that matched the sticker exactly on the back, and then just took the back off that, put it on here, and there you go. So looks great now overall, and now it's actually kind of worth the rocket value that I was charged, which it wasn't before, but I couldn't really see it ahead of time, and I didn't really look because I was being lazy about my standards. So, you know. Another game I got at that store was this box copy of Konami Collector Series Arcade Advanced, which includes six great arcade games, as it says. I mainly got it for Gyrus, because I like Gyrus a lot, and hey, MGBA Gyrus, you know. But there's some other cool things. You got Russian Attack, Scramble, Time Pilot, Frogger, and Gyar Kung Fu. Most of those are, I guess, fine. I'm not a Frogger fan, so fuck Frogger, but whatever. It's kind of neat. It's early 80s, it's actually just plain 80s Konami arcade games, but yeah, most of them are from mid to early 80s, but Gyrus is definitely the newest one of the bunch, for sure. But yeah, it's complete in box, a little crushed, but it's what you get when you want complete in box, cardboard boxed copies of games, you know. Unfortunately, a lot of times that's what happens. But not too bad. The other thing I got here was this controller I've been looking out, maybe getting from Amazon for a while now, but I'm always wary of third-party controllers for, you know, new third-party controllers for old systems. It's usually a shitstorm of crap quality, as you might expect. So I took the plunge to try this because I saw they had this at that store I went to in Mount Vernon, so I thought, I'm here, it's here, I'll just give it a shot. They didn't charge any more than regular price, which is $12 for this thing, which is not too bad a price. So I got this Hyperkin Cadet NES controller, as they call it. There's a all-black version as well. It has these weird tapered edges because that's what Hyperkin likes to do in their packaging. So they decided to put it on this controller. Thankfully, it doesn't actually change any the feel of it, which is good. So, regarding the quality, I'm actually very surprised. I just played some Double Dragon 3 with it. Tested it out, played through most of the game with it, actually. it was very responsive. It was actually really good. I was really surprised. I've heard good things about it beforehand, but, you know, I don't trust people because usually they don't have the standards I have. They just don't. They have shit standards. Just be honest. So, but yeah, it looks, you can see the buttons and the D-pad, everything looks a lot like the original controller from the actual NES. Outside those weird corners, which doesn't impact anything, which is good, like I said. But they do have the raised sides here on the back, which also doesn't really impact anything, surprisingly. It kind of feels a tiny bit better, if anything, but I don't know. Didn't change anything, so it's not bad. The good thing is that the quality of the buttons, the D-pad pretty much feels spot on to the original, which is exactly what you want. Same with the start and select. So, I would say, if I'm going to give it a recommendation, I think it's worthy of you picking it up if you're looking for newer NES controllers that aren't old used ones. Because, you know, those can be hit and miss as well, because they're just old. So, this I definitely recommend. $12 is all you should pay, or less. It's really worth it, I would say. And we also have some newer stuff. So, I picked up and played through Coded Princess EX on the Switch. It's my newest Switch game so far. And yeah, it's Coded Princess, but from the 3DS, but now it's on Switch and has better visuals, you know. Obviously, higher resolution. Looks nicer. They didn't change, they didn't remake it or anything, they just made it nicer looking through higher resolution. And of course it's pointing out Guardian Heroes, which I went back and played again on my Saturn. So, it's pretty good. It's pretty worth it, I would say. The the first print runs have reversible covers. You can kind of tell that that is actually the same cover art as the 3DS version. And then we have, this is sad, but we're in the era of manuals or bonus extras now. That's what this is. It's a bonus extra. It's a sad state we live in. Really pathetic. I have a few other games of current gen stuff that have manuals, but it's super uncommon at this point. And as you saw when I've taken it out, you have this mini CD. I'm surprised anyone makes these anymore. But in order to fit it in this case, you have to have it that way, I guess. But this is a worthless pile of trash because it's just another one of those sampler soundtrack CDs where you get a few tracks. Those things always infuriate me because they're just worthless. Like, there's no point. You could have saved yourself some money and not given it to me. I would have been happier, honestly. Because it's just, there's no point to it. Like, you get a few tracks and soundtrack. Oh boy, exciting. Good thing I don't like the soundtrack in this game. Because if I did, it'd make me more mad. It'd make me more pissed off. But I don't, so whatever. Still think they're dumb, though, and they're a waste of time. Another one I've just picked up is Detective Pikachu. Why did I pick this up? I'm not a Pac-Man fan. The only Pokemon games I own outside of this are like the Game Boy Pokemon pinball games or things like that. So, you know, not the proper games. And this is also not a proper game. But why I want it? Because you got gruff-sounding Pikachu speaking full English. That's just the funniest thing to me, so I had to have it. It's pretty much the only reason. Like, I'm not joking, so. I've basically heard from actual fans of Pokemon that, yeah, that's pretty much the reason to get it. So, hey, I'm in for the win, I guess, or something. Something stupid phrase like that. I got some PS4 stuff here to top it off here. Still have a sealed copy of Tempest 4000. It just came out not too long ago for really cheap, and it's actually physically made, which is surprising. Good old, what's his face? The one who made Tempest 2000, Space Giraffe, TXK. Well, this is basically TXK, but an official Tempest game, because he pretty much got sued by Atari over that Vita game, which I think is great, by the way. But this looks like it's basically the same thing, so. And I know for a fact it has the TXK soundtrack in this game as well, which is awesome, because I actually bought that separately after the fact years ago, because it's great. I don't know necessarily I recommend Tempest 4000, I just like Tempest, so I recently played Tempest X3 on PlayStation 1, which is essentially Tempest 2000 ported over and from the Jaguar. We have a Undernight Inbirth Exilate, or I'm sorry, Undernight Inbirth Exilatest, because without the ST on the end, it's actually the PS3, or previous version on PS3, which I also have. So, there's another, what, equal French bread thing or something? Yeah, French bread. Okay. So, it's another fighting game, of course, to play. Gotta have those. And yes, I did it. I picked up Shenmue 1 and 2. I never played these before. I've heard lots of people gush over them with unspecific praise. And I don't understand that. Because when I hear people actually talk about it specifically, with actual criticism, it doesn't sound so great. But all the super fans talk about it in really, you know, just very vague ways. Oh, I love it, so great, blah, blah, blah. You know, they just don't say anything specific. And my guess is I won't like them that much. But I'll be the judge. I'll actually play them. I'll give it a chance. I'm not going to be a negative about it. Don't worry. So, I did this mainly. I pulled this trigger now because I think it was the weird situation of BestBuy.com usually is like, you know, usually it's the whole thing of, I want to say, sometimes like it's like, oh, you can buy it online, but it's not available in your store or whatever, something like that. It's just pretty common sometimes. This is the opposite. This is like, oh, it's not available online, but yeah, so you have to get it in store. And I'm like, oh shit. And my store actually had some copies, so I was like, okay, well, I'll just go get this now before I miss my chance, or this wasn't printed much or something, I don't know. So, So I just ended up picking it up early on anyway, even though I didn't intend to. My last PS4 game here, and of course the best one, is Yakuza Kiwami 2, which I would have had this on release day, but usually what I do with Best Buy is I like to, when they offer the option, I like to pick up in store on release day. I don't know why, I just do. It's something I like to do. Well, this was the first time when they were like, release day comes around, usually I get the email that says, oh, it's ready to pick up. Not that day, not that day. That day I was like, it said, got an email saying, oh, we can't ship at the store. I'm like, what? Why? You gave me the option. I did it months ago. Just do it. Nope. So I had to change the option to ship to me. It took another 2 days. So that sucked ass. But it's here finally. And, well, I gotta change this around a little bit here. This is not the correct cover you really want. This is the one you really want. See, you gotta have Go to Ryuji on it, on front. Just switch it around. That's how you want it. That's the real guy. And we have, finally, two special edition controllers. Now, this is also kind of a pithy little private industry versus socialism little argument I'm about to make here, because it's kind of funny. Because I bought two of these from, one from Amazon and one from Best Buy, because I couldn't buy two at Best Buy, so I couldn't, you know, just wouldn't let me. Would not let me. So, I want to say this is what a private industry gets you. It gets you a crushed box, as you can see. This is from UPS. UPS shipped this. This is the Amazon shipment. This is what it gets you. Gets you a shit box. Gets you shit. Okay? See, but the Best Buy order came exclusively from socialism, alright, from the U.S. Postal Service, and you get a perfect box from socialism. So see, this is why you don't want greedy capitalism, you want socialism, you see what I'm saying? That's how it works. Anyway, I'll get back to what this is really about. This is the DualShock 4 500 million limited edition, like the console they brought out the same day, which was back on about a week ago or so. And, I didn't get the console. I already have a Pro. I didn't feel like getting another one just for the colors. But I can buy controllers, and that's fun. That's always fun. So I did. So I'm keeping one sealed. Not necessarily for value or collector's purposes, but kind of. It's the same thing I did with the, back in 2015 when they released the gray 20th anniversary DualShock 4s separately. I got two of those and I still have one sealed as well. But here's the open one, as you can see. It's very, very purple. Very, very premium, as Sony's official unboxing video would tell you. Very premium. So that's quite nice. A little dusty. It's been sitting around for a few days. But it's very nice. I haven't used it yet. That's why it doesn't have any covers on the analog sticks yet. But it's cool. It's great. It's here. I love it. It's very premium. So thanks for watching, and that is all.